Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Playhouse SmithVille and to our production of The Tubes. This is our 91st production, my first production of The Tubes, which I wrote as a short story years ago, sold it, and then decided to turn it into a play many years later. At any rate, there are, please turn off your cell phones or your beepers if you happen to be a 1980s and there's strobe lights. I don't know if that could cause anybody problems. There's a couple of scenes, short time with strobe lighting, so just to let you know. And welcome and enjoy the show. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. of these thoughts come to me. Is it thunder, echoing, sounds reverberating inside my skull?
He thinks.
Where did these two come from? First one, then the other. Where did they come from?
Curious beings.
These curious beings, this wandering philosopher.
And this genus of man, yet removed from man. Where have they come from?
Come from the ice floes. Into the mountains, and through the forests. Always moving forward, yet I never felt compelled. And I came down into this desert. I never knew any language. Not before my grunts and howls. Until he showed up. Him, who I could not avoid.
He speaks with words.
Why had they come here? Have we not called them from our graves?
Have we not called them from our graves in a singular mutilation? Outrage?
No. I'll have locked on you. Torn from my rocking chair along the alluvial fields of Mississippi. Upon the road I had labored down from Memphis to New Orleans. Barging my bicycle ever since. In the bios across Beaver, Texas, just collecting metal and whatever I think I might sell. Dreaming ever of the Pacific's lapis shores.
I hear.
And the quiet turning of my gears, I began to hear the lament and horror of the horrors buried beneath the howl of the highway. Sometimes I could not help but pray for their tortured souls.
I hear 100 leagues on. Coming with sorrow. Sorrow in his engines. Sorrow in the singing whine of his 18 wheels.
Ronnie, honey, we're gonna stop up here in a little bit. Got a bit of fun we used to have. Why, who's that ahead of me? I think it's Henry.
Let me go, Buck. Please let me go.
Whimpering and sniveling. Just like every other Jezebel, whimpering and sniveling. Till you make me do something to make it stop.
Breaker 1-9, this here is 12-point Buck coming at you, Henry, right up ahead of me.
He is a killer. Giver of pain!
I didn't know then that I could affect change, nor how to ameliorate the lamentations of those so afflicted.
I found the bones of his discarded lovers, buried hastily beneath these red desert sands. Oh, how I could rend his face, scream devastation and crab his very spine.
There, outside of Skiro, I hid my bicycle amidst a copse of greasewood, searched for the source of this woe. I knew I could not move forward until I touched him, until I felt his heartbeat, until at least I knew his tail. But as I moved, he would move. Like the coyote, he swam through the desert as if it were a sea of spew.
I put fragrant flowers on their graves. Cried for them. And I would lay on them, absorbing all their grief, sorrow, pain, so they could move on to something more glorious.
I could not see him. He would not let me, though he wanted me near. We traveled parallel, close enough that I could live within his thoughts. When he dreamed, pictures, never words, came to him as they came to me. Lonely. Lonely. Just ever so lonely.
Lonely. Lonely. Ever so lonely.
He harbored no violence. I couldn't sense a wit as could ever be sensed in the meekest of men. Was he not a man? Not a man, but something else? He would not kill, not even to feed himself. Though he would eat a meat if it were killed upon the highway. He would haunt the kill of the mountain lion like a starved and lean jackal, like animals patiently awaiting the spoils of the dead.
What horrors must I witness? I hear the coming of the 18-wheeled beast, and I sense a sorceress of a woman's desperate plea. Is this another victim? I thought as long as I would hear, he would not dare bring any more. That I would be a lightning rod for the rapture he finds in rage.
Suddenly I was stricken, miles and miles from where I first encountered the creature whom I could not help but follow. Perhaps I prayed for such an opportunity to meet him, for I know he lives in empathy to all within his radius. I'm stricken.
My mind is torn from the mind of man. I feel the pain of somebody else. What is it? It is he who has been following me, who I have let follow me. His pain is screaming pain.
That burns like magma close to my insides. Let's call for help. I know he will not understand the word, but he will know the need is urgent.
He falls.
Beside these very tubes.
Wind howls. Toss me through the thistle and the tumbleweeds. Screen like spike in my skin. I can taste the sand on my tongue. I feel it coat the philosopher's tongue. I roar as I exhale. Every last breath is out.
I call for help. I do not scream at all. I think less than a wheeze of a gale. Yet, I feel him approach.
Do not wish to help him. Men have only been pain to me. He is a man, yet not a man. I can let him die, or I can comfort him. My path is made clear. I go to him, reluctantly.
Pain comes again worse than ever before.
He is the philosopher.
How do you speak?
It's past.
You spoke.
I spoke.
Does it make you afraid?
Yes. What do you think? I've always been alone, but free. Not trapped like a man. These roads and houses, money, and this language.
It is a gift, a given for a reason.
You gave it to me.
Not I.
You gave me the word when you gave me the stone. Not that pain, pure and primitive, but the word, pain.
The language did not come from me.
The stone came from you. I felt the exchange.
And that was your gift to me, taking my stone to my pain.
I gave you nothing but comfort. You gave me the stone. This curse. This language!
I gave you nothing but someone to care for. And you took my stone out of empathy.
Empathy? What the hell is empathy? Well, go now. You have your cure? Get on out of here.
It's just barking of a chihuahua.
I will tear your throat out if you stay. You're not afraid.
There is no violence in you. Not to benefit yourself. No, I'm not afraid.
I have wrestled with mountain lions. I have howled with coyotes. I have pulled the venom from snakes.
But you will not kill, not even to save your own flesh.
True.
Is this your home that you can command me to go?
I have no home.
You do. This is your home until it is not.
Do I look like a madman to you? Here in these tubes, the rains are coming, and with them, the force, the power of the mountains will come streaming down and clean all this way and wash me and render me asunder.
You will hear it coming from miles away. And when it does come, you'll be standing atop the arroyo's edge, watching in wonder as it washes your tubes clean.
I might. Why would I stay?
Because I command it.
You? Who are you?
No one, just a hobo upon the road. Who are you?
You tell me you don't know? You've been following me all these days.
You could have run away.
I could not. I tried.
So I am the one you could not run away from. I'm the one who tells you that you must stay here. And you will leave. But you will come back again and again. You will keep coming back to this place until you are finished with it.
Why is this place so important?
I haven't a motherfucking clue.
Stop, please. You're confusing me. This language is new.
Do you pretend to not know who I am?
I do not know. I have felt you. All this time, I have felt you near me. No matter how far I ran to get away, I always come back closer to you, to this place, like an animal to an interesting spore.
Is there a word that arises in your mind? Tell you the truth, I would like to know who I am.
Not a name.
No, not a name. I got a name. I got a whole bunch of names.
Sis.
So?
Do I have a name?
It's a question to ponder. I will tell you when you have told me what you have sensed.
You smell like a philosopher.
That seems a little vague.
Shaman, then.
Shaman? Can a shaman command you?
No one can command me.
Can a shaman make suggestions?
I would listen to a shaman.
And you must stay here.
I will not. Stay. Not until you tell me who I am.
You are the man in the maze.
Well, that seems a little vague.
Let me see if I can explain. You're primitive. No, maybe primitive is not the right word. You are ancient.
With language.
And I think not. Not to the great mass of men. See, to you, you will speak to them and it will sound garbled, primitive, laughable. They laugh at their own primitive hearts. Now, with me and one other, will your tongue uncurl? Will your words flow smoothly?
What up?
Oh, I've said too much already.
Who am I? Where did I come from?
Oh, it beats me. You just seem to have always been.
I sense that from you as well.
Have you? See, I thought I knew my beginning, but now that I've talked to you, I'm not so sure.
Who am I?
I will begin again. You are primitive. You are the heart of man and woman. You are the part that they deny, yet without you they cannot exist. You are what mankind could have been. You're what mankind has chosen to forget. You are life and you are death. You are immortality, and you are mortality. You are hunger. You are feasting. See, you are the man who walks through the maze without being lost. And you are the man who returns from the maze with the hair of death's head tangled in your fingers. You are justice.
Ah! I just live, that is all.
Oh, you live, but most would have you dead.
Dead? What is dead?
Have you not seen it?
Of course. An animal dies, only to live again when it is eaten.
Dead, only gone, not eaten. Desiccated, blown by the wind, you know, nourishment for nothing.
It's unimaginable. Who am I?
Well, I can tell you no more. They will call you Dog Boy, and names more violent, to stay here.
Well, I will not stay.
But you must.
I will not. I must leave this place.
Here in this place, an evil dwells. Can you not smell it?
I smell the trees. I smell half-eaten hamburgers and chickens and buns. I've eaten of these things.
And you will again if you stay here. Smell further.
Smell ozone. Coming down from the mountains. The lightning sears the air. I smell animals. Creatures great and small. They're afterbirth, their essence, their death. I smell the fumes of man. I smell his fears, his exaltations, his... Ah! Ah!
What is it?
What do you want from me? What am I supposed to smell?
Is it evil?
It's dark. It's congealed. Like a node in the heart that has no light. Penetrated or nothing.
So?
So, I've got to get out of here.
Oh, can you?
I will come back. But I can do nothing against this evil.
Only observe. Your presence will disturb the evil. The evil will torture you, and in the end, said too much already. You are justice. You are empathy.
Down onto Okatillo and creosote bushes.
First time I saw him, I knew him for the monster he was. He was leaning up against his truck, drinking green beer, down in these black, black pills. What the fuck? I could read his thoughts. I sensed that he could feel me pulling them from him.
Others. I sense
They do not enjoy my pain and humiliation as much as he does, and yet they do his bidding as if it somehow makes them higher on the testosterone scale. None are as cool as he. I thought, as long as he had me to torment, he would not bring any others. And until now, there have been no fresh graves dug in these sands. Now he has another victim. I tell myself that I will stop it. I've told myself this many, many times before, and I have failed.
Wretched harlot, bespoiled waif, why do you come to me?
I come to you for comfort. You are my mother, heart salve, embracing arms.
You come to me stained with the stench of your sins.
Can you not forgive me?
Forgive? Forgive? It's a mother's lot to forgive. Yet I strain to touch you. I recoil from you.
As it ever was, even as a pure and innocent child.
Pure? Never were you pure. Even as a child held against my breast, I longed to dash your brains against the garden wall.
Was I so loathsome? Or was it you?
Sensing violence, your father watched me quite closely. Those eyes set deep in his long goat's face. Feigning love for you, and only loathing me.
He did love me.
He loved no one. He was weak!
Do you call him weak because he was gentle?
He couldn't always protect you from me. Nay, I couldn't bruise your flesh, but I could pierce you with words and delight in your girlish tears.
He would never believe any ill of you, even if I told him of your barbed rants.
He was weak. He inflicted you on me, and I cursed him.
Cancer?
The cancer ate him alive as I had willed it, almost as if I had bewitched him.
Curse me also?
Oh, yes, I did.
What curse? What form will it take?
Oh, it's already taken form, my dear. Compounded 1,000 times by your father's uninvited curse upon you.
My father did not curse me!
You know.
How then? I cannot trust the words you utter, spiteful scorpion that you are!
believe me or believe me not, but observe the curse within yourself and know of its power.
Speak plainly.
From the time of your father's death, coinciding with the blooming of your young body, you searched, confused, damned to love false gold, and watch it turn black and brackish with your touch.
It is true. Your wicked charm has stricken me blind.
He loved you when he first saw you. He did love me. And I loved him. But once you came, no more.
He did. But the scales of jealousy sealed your mind.
I should have harmed you so.
Wake now! Awake!
Believe her not!
Save yourself! It is within your grasp!
Thank you.
boy. Don't those nasty old truck horns get thrown anymore? Aren't you gonna give us a show?
Maybe we have deaf stuff. You reckon we did?
Oh, hell no, stupid. Can't make something deaf just by tooting at it. Besides, old caveman. I mean, old dog boy don't want to play no more.
She has escaped. I heard the hinge break. I smell her. She is working her way towards me, towards this place. Come out of there. He will find you in there.
Shh, damn it! You're still out there! Can't you hear?
You smell sweet. Desert rain.
I told you, he will hear you.
I hear him. I smell him. Diesel and death commingle. He hears me not. But he is thinking of you right now. I can smell his lust and hatred, like night, black night, swallowing the sunset.
You can smell all that?
Yes. And I can smell you, different than me. I've waited long for the smell of you, for the touch of you, for the taste of you. Sage flowers in the wind.
Hapless, out of the frying pan and into the fire and out of the fryer into a level of hell, staring at a demon, stripped of all of his human form. Man, I can call you creature. You, like this, are filled with lust and foul temperament.
See you a demon?
What else can describe you?
Demon I am. Though I feel as an angel towards you, I will not rape you or kill you. Not like that broad-browed beast above. I will protect you if you let me.
If I can ignore your brutish looks and incessant sniffing.
What is an angel anyway? A tall being, a shining visage, wiping the soot off his wings while all those look upon him with adoration.
Back off. Look the other way. He could come back any minute looking for me.
I am only for you. I know that now. I see that. No, no, I smell it. I smell it with my brain and with the tendrils that ensnare my very heart.
I'll scream. I swear it. I don't care if Buck finds me. I don't care if he black snakes me from here to Tucumcari. One thing for sure, he and his friends will kill you dead for a pervert. They'll chain an arm and a leg to a truck going east, and a leg and an arm to a truck going west, and you'll rip Sunny Jim like a meat phone book. You'll rip.
You're angry. I know underneath your heart is true.
Sir Gawain of the overhung brow.
Ronnie, you're a sleaze, plain and simple. Smart, but a sleaze. Him what lives by sex and the boys dies with the smell of rot on him.
Silence, you virulent bitch! Be gone, you heedless, tiresome ghost! What leather your wings enfolded you upon your death?
The look of horror in your eyes.
The singe and sulfur smell of you as if hellfire even then licked at your feet.
Be gone, you heedless, tiresome ghost! What leathery wings enfolded you upon your death? That look of horror in your eyes. The singed and sulfur smell as if hellfire licked at your own feet.
What other horrors torture you?
Please, get off the ground.
but I will not allow it. Not this time.
I'm damned. He will find me.
I'll help you. Shh, shh, shh.
Well, I best hit the road, bud. Gotta be in Tucson by the time to run out the streets. There's nothing here to sell but fuel.
Yeah.
He spits. He can hear his engines, the grind of his gears as he pulls away.
That you, dog boy? Beating me up the bushes over there? You keep watching, I'll see something. Ooh-wee, baby, your perfume's so sweet, I could just eat you. Feel you lying up there in that cabin. I can smell it. Can you smell it, caveman? She just woke up and having dirty dreams about me. Just a minute, I'm coming for you. You know something about this, you ditch dwelling vermin?
We rise. We take a stand upon this ground. The evil dares to come full circle and tread and spit upon our sorrow-filled shades. Watch you now. Witness the machination of retribution land upon the man.
Some deformed ape like you?
That's what you think.
Get out of my way! Look at that bimbo! She will not get you not today! When I look in your head, I see things that I can't even imagine. I want to tear your heart out. I want to see you lying dead!
What are you muttering? If you would have been able to kill me, you would have already. You know what I've done? I saw you see me dig in that grave. You cowered like a woman. Like all those women. How their squeals and whimpers gave me power over them. Just like with you.
No! Get out of here! She will not die today! Not today! Go! Or go with your will! This is how you die!
Until I could hear him bellowing no longer. my name upon his poisonous tongue. Ronnie, 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 and bellowing rage and anguish.
A river with no water.
But the arroyo seemed like the only safe place to be.
Bleached sand and in the hand.
The creature, the thing, the being, the heart, the man? Not as dangerous. I can see the lightning. The thunderheads are gathering, but no rain falls here. The dirt is as dry as salt. Wrong color, metallic green. Oh, what can I do? Oh, sweet Jesus.
Mister?
Oh, sweet Jesus, you're hurt!
It's nothing.
You're crying. A great big monster like you?
Sometimes when we cry for happiness.
Happiness? What could you possibly be happy about? You're hurt, bleeding. These rags are nasty. I'll get you something clean.
No, no, please don't go. Nothing. I cry because you are here. You're home.
Home? Get a clue, dog boy.
Home. Even if just for today. Just for now.
That bastard did this to you. He hurt you, didn't he?
I'll be okay.
God, you're ugly.
I have been told.
I suppose you have. I'm gonna clean you up now.
God, by death, I've never been so stupid. Never let one get away from me. That mutt got in the way. You got away teaching that bitch a lesson. I got his goddamn blood all over me. I don't think I killed him. He can't talk, but she can.
What mutt?
Who the fuck are you?
You picked me up. I was hitchhiking, don't you remember?
Bullshit! I never pick up hitchhikers!
Well, explain to me just how I happened to be riding shotgun with you at this very moment.
I never pick up hitchhikers. Especially hitchhikers like you.
Like me? What? Ragged?
Goddamn right, ragged. I'm looking like a hobo, smelly and stinky. You take a damn pick.
What mutt?
Shut up if you want to ride.
What mutt?
Dog jumped out in front of the truck.
Dog? A dog that can't talk?
Yeah, a dog. You ever heard of a dog that can talk?
And how did the dog's blood get all over you?
I went out to see if it was all right.
You went out to check on a dog that had been flattened out by a Mack truck?
It's a Peterbilt.
And the dog, what, was it all right?
It was gone. There was a lot of blood.
And she?
She?
She, the one you were mumbling about, the one who can talk? Or did she get flattened out too?
If you want to ride, you better shut up!
No, but so you said this mutt helped a she get away. Just how did that happen?
Comes to it, you don't know how to shut up. So you can just get the hell out of my rig. I'm going back. I'm turning it around.
Back where?
Shut up!
And get out. No, I won't.
What do you mean you won't?
And you're not turning this rig around either.
The hell you say? I'll do what I want.
Try it.
Won't do anything except go straight ahead.
I guess that's what you have to do then. Go straight ahead.
I've got to go straight ahead.
That's where you seem to be headed.
I've got to go straight ahead.
You've got to deliver this trailer full of bowling shoes.
I've got to deliver the trailer full of bowling shoes.
All the way to Los Angeles.
All the way to Los Angeles.
And you won't think about any mud or any sheen until every last shoe is unloaded.
Until every last shoe is unloaded.
Just then, you might think about going back. Then will be the time, the right time.
The right time.
We can let me off right about here. Thank you kindly for the ride.
My pleasure.
Staring at the carnage he cannot understand. one of the pitiless ones. His eyes, reflecting the fire of their torches, jab something sharp and deadlier to his gentler. Ah, no more!
Look at him and try to understand.
There sits Dog Boy, but not Dog Boy, popping in and out of existence, each life formed out of sand and soon returned to the void, unfulfilled, a victim of human violence.
And then?
It's Dog Boy this time, born of nothing, conceived of a shout of a choir of mutes. His mind.
Can you feel how he thinks?
I feel a web of empty current. Instincts, scent, salivation. Until you led him to these tubes. You gave him a voice and made him lift here, demeaned, waiting.
Waiting for you. Shh, tell him. Say nothing more. I will tell you his name.
Alone, she could swim naked in the lake, and in the lake, she had no lift. This is Cassie, short for Cassandra, from Alaska originally. She always told everyone that, even though she had never been. She liked to start up conversations with men in the bars. She liked to make things up about herself to seem more interesting. Sometimes she'd say right off the bat without a prelude, "Entertain me." That's what she said to Bob. She said, "Entertain me." This is Louise. So country it hurts, from some holler in Tennessee. Raw-boned, yet eager. It seemed to her Buck was smart. It seemed to her Buck knew just about everything. She could see the whole world from the view of his windshield, just like he did if she would just jump on up.
I can see him. I could always see him.
They never talked to me, told me anything. Somehow they led me here, to this place.
Can you hear what they're saying now? It's love, fool. Love they know they cannot fulfill. You have always thought that they wanted you to stay here out of the hate of the man. Because their undocumented deaths required vengeance. No. They saw what was coming for you, and they wanted you to have love, even if it was for one night, 1 hour.
Love?
Deep feelings. They could never leave you. You are their entire world.
Love. Philosopher says I have empathy. Empathy? Empathy?
Not just empathy. Love. Love. Oh, sweet Jesus, look who you're asking.
You don't know what love is either? Is that love?
What do you think? I was the love they saw coming. Do you feel something?
On the first day that I smelled you.
Now do you feel something else? Something new?
Does this mean you love me too? I hope so. Do it again.
Insanity.
The synapses of the monster's true mind bald and hot like lightning in the mountains.
He awakens in a motel room in San Bernardino, writhing in sweat, wondering where he has been.
How had he wandered here since offloading his cargo in Los Angeles?
Where am I going?
And then he remembers who he is. He perceives at the darkness of the core of his soul.
He remembers who he must kill and why. The time is right. It is the coming of darkness.
It is the coming of justice.
The stars are aligned.
The waters coalesce into the mountains, streams, and rivulets.
And onward to diesel comes, engine hot and steam.
Bringing doom, bringing the final thread of our tale to its conclusion.
How will our beloved fare? Judgment.
Under a bridge!
His eyes were growing green at me in there. I told him I'd gather everything that would burn. Driftwood logs, tumbleweeds, trash, and I stuffed the pot. Doused the whole thing in diesel. Still wouldn't come out. Screw him and screw you. So I cranked the wheel of my Zippo and I tossed it. Looks like you needed it. One less time for the road. One less time for sluts.
No, no. Dogboy! Dogboy, save me!
Shall we keep it simple in the end?
Yes.
Whenever he has been awaiting, I count.
Ronnie found some clothes, but still running hater bills.
It's Dr. Friedrich. This is how we're in.
Alrighty, the microscopic cells divide and divide and divide within her womb.
And the dormant desert plants soot their soggy hue and explode into rapturous bloom.
Thank you. I mean, it's not at all.